Hi, I'm Steven from Woken Tech, and this is my laptop. Whoa, hey, don't click out. I know it sounds crazy, but hear me out. You see, this phone has a built-in feature called Samsung DeX, which can turn a phone's UI to a desktop-style UI, with all the floating windows, taskbar, and keyboard and mouse capabilities. I've been testing this feature for about 4 months now, as I wanted to see if it could replace my laptop when I go to law school. So, how does it perform? Let's talk about it. Alright, let's set the scene. If I want to make this work for law school, I need to make sure that DeX can do these things properly. I need to be able to write notes quickly, because those lectures can be insanely packed with info, use the office apps without any problem, part and parcel of being a student, browse the web comfortably when doing research papers, and edit videos. Because I'm the editor of Broken Tech, sometimes I need to do rush edits here and there. Everything else outside of these can wait until I get home to my PC. So this means I needed a few stuff to make this work. A portable monitor, as DeX needs a monitor to work, a Bluetooth mouse and keyboard, a USB-C 3.1, which thankfully came with the monitor I bought, and obviously, my phone, the Galaxy S21 FE. All of this totaled to roughly 30,000 Philippine pesos. So with all of these plugged in and paired up, how does DeX fare? Pretty well, actually. My main note-taking app is OneNote, and while it does have a few problems here and there, if you know what you're doing, taking notes is absolutely no problem. It can work more or less like the PC variant, with a few minor limitations. As for the Office apps, both the Google Workspace and Microsoft 365 apps are actually optimized for DeX. So while not perfect, you can still properly work on your documents, sheets, slides, without much problem. The browsing experience feels just like it would on the desktop, if your browser supports it. I use Samsung Internet, which completely changes its UI and every site to be that of the desktop browser. It can even open new tabs in an entirely new window. And with DeX's window snapping feature, similar to that of Windows, it's a huge plus for someone like me, who often needs to see like 3 or 4 windows at once when studying or doing homework. Google Chrome can do all of these too, though I haven't been able to try opening new tabs in the new window. Let me know if it can. I did have quite a problem though when trying to find a proper video editor. You see, I need an editor on my phone just for rush edits, which may or may not happen frequently, so subscriptions were out of the question. But I also kinda need one that has keyboard support for shortcuts, as I need to work quickly when doing rush edits. I tried CapCut, VN, KineMaster, PowerDirector, Viva Video, every single popular video editing app on the Play Store, and all of them were either free but lacked keyboard support, or they were subscription-based. The only one I saw that had keyboard support and was not subscription-based was LumaFusion, which, at the time of this recording, cost in a one-time payment of roughly 800 Philippine pesos in the Samsung store. Hey, it's Future Steven here, and after trying to use LumaFusion to edit this video, I can already tell you that I've given up. While it is really good for rush edits, my problem is that with my workflow and my editing style, it just doesn't work. We'll be using DaVinci Resolve for this video from now on. Back to you, Pat Steven. So that's great. It can take notes quickly, manage office apps nicely, and edit videos on the fly, all while still feeling like a desktop. Kinda. You see, while DeX is good for the basics of school, work, browsing, and content creation, it still has quite a lot of problems that every user is bound to run into more often than not. While DeX is advertised as a desktop experience, it's still just an Android phone that's simply mimicking a desktop. You're still locked to only Android apps, and many of these apps are very unoptimized for DeX, leading to weird displays and the occasional crashes. While some of these do have a browser variant as a workaround, such as Facebook and Twitter, it can nevertheless be quite the inconvenience to some. But I think the biggest deal breaker for many people is that it's only available to a very limited set of Samsung phones, particularly the Galaxy S series, Note series, Fold series, and the S series tablets. So if you're on a budget, the most affordable option available is the FE series. Not the best, especially since it overheats quite easily, more so when you start doing really heavy tasks. At least it has no problem running work-related tasks. But I think what really makes DeX a really interesting feature is just how good it is, being as lightweight as you need it to be. Unlike a traditional laptop that gives you the entire package on a thin slab, or a thick one if you're a gamer, DeX allows you to pick how much you want to include in the desktop experience. Don't want to bring your mouse and keyboard? Don't worry! You can use your phone as a trackpad and a virtual keyboard. There's already a monitor or TV around? Get a USB-C to HDMI cable or adapter and just plug and play. No need for a portable monitor anymore. Heck, if the TV or monitor supports Miracast, you don't even need the cable anymore. You can just connect the TV or monitor wirelessly to activate DeX. It's up to you if you want to bring a monitor, mouse, keyboard for the full desktop experience, or if you just want to bring nothing but your phone. Finally, no need to find a place to set your laptop. No need for those long HDMI cables. With just your phone, you can watch the anime you definitely downloaded illegally, hold a PowerPoint presentation, or even use PlayStation or Xbox's remote play feature. Some mobile games like Conquest Star Rail even have controller support, allowing you to play on the TV with just your phone and controller. There's so much potential with what you could do with nothing but your phone. So, after 4 months of testing Samsung DeX, can it actually replace a laptop? For me, yeah. For others, probably not. It's good at basic work-related tasks, but it's extremely unoptimized and far from polished. But it's also a great way to maintain a very portable and lightweight setup that's tailored to your needs. So while your phone with DeX may not be a full-fledged laptop, it's still good at preserving the desktop experience while staying as portable as you need it to be. I don't think DeX is good enough to replace your laptop, unless you have a dedicated PC at home, but it's still a great addition to your arsenal, especially just because of how much you can get from so little. And with that, thanks so much for watching. Thanks so much for sticking around to the very end. I'll see y'all in the next video. Bye for now.